So the first law of chemical composition, the first law was named as law of conservation of mass. So I will first tell the meaning of conservation in Hindi. The mother tongue is Hindi. Conservation means bacha hua rehta hai. Kuch koi cheez bachi rehti chemical action ke dauran. Lafz pata chal jayega aapko. Listen the definition. According to this law, during any physical or chemical change, the mass of the reactants is always equal to the mass of the products. That is, mass, or you can say matter, is conserved. I mean to say, I again repeat the meaning of conservation, that is, it is not destroyed. This matter is not destroyed. As I have said earlier, the mass of the reactants is always equal to the mass of the products. You can take an example of a physical change related to this law. We have ice having weight 50 gram. When it is converted to water, the water again weighs 50 gram. And if you freeze water again to ice, the mass remains same, 50 gram, 50 gram, or 50 gram, 50 gram. Second example is of a chemical change. It's a very simple chemical change. If we want to decompose 100 gram calcium carbonate, as you know, calcium carbonate decomposes to give calcium oxide and CO2 gas. If you don't allow this CO2 gas to get of the reactants, then if you have weighed CaCO3 is 100 gram, then after weighing these two products as, suppose CO observed was 90 gram and CO2 gas observed was 10 gram. If you add this 90 plus 10, you again make 100 gram. In the starting, you have taken 100 gram calcium carbonate, and at the end of the reaction, you get 100 gram products. This is a very simple law of conservation of mass. There is a very simple numerical related to law of conservation of mass has been written on the blackboard. You first understood the statement of the numerical. The numerical is saying, when 4.2 gram of baking soda having formula NaHCO3, it has been added to a solution of acetic acid having formula CH3COOH whose weight was 10 gram. It was observed that 2.2 gram of CO2 gas is released in the atmosphere, and the residue which has left behind shows the weight of 12 gram. You have to simply illustrate the law of conservation of mass. Now we come to the solution of the numerical. According to the law of conservation of mass, you already studied mass of the reactants are always equal to the mass of the products. Okay, let's say it equation number 1. Then you have to write the reaction. In the reaction, this is a reactant and another reactant is this. So you write on the left hand side CH3COOH plus NaHCO3. When they react together, they give a residue. So you must know how to write the reaction. This is a reaction of 10th class. So this is an acid, this is a base. So CH3COO release H, gets Na plus in place of H. So this is your salt, sodium acetate, and water and CO2 gas. So residue is this, sodium acetate and water act as residue and CO2 gas. Then you have to write their masses. CH3COH has weight 10 gram. Baking soda has weight 4.2 gram. Residue has weight 10 gram, 12 gram. And CO2 shows the weight of 2.2 gram. Now, using first, you just add the weight of the reactants 10 plus 4.2 gram is equal to 12 plus 2.2 gram. This weight becomes 14.2 gram. This weight again becomes 14.2 gram. So this numerical is also showing that 14.2 gram of the reactants remain conserved after the reaction, and the product is also showing the weight of 14.2 gram.